Hello and welcome back to your own channel Indian Defense Analysis, where we bring to you all the latest development happening in the defense sector.
French Defense Minister Florence Parly is set to visit India on 17th and 18th December 2021. This visit is very crucial for India-French bilateral relations. The French minister is slated to have talks with her Indian counterpart Rajnath Singh in New Delhi on December 17th. The speculations are high about the French offering of nuclear-powered submarine under the umbrella of Make in India scheme. There are further possibilities that France can sweeten its offer for more Rafale under MRFA, that is Multi-Role Fighter Aircraft Program. In this video, we will purely focus on French offerings of nuclear-powered submarine, as we have already made a detailed video on Rafale. The link for the same can be found in the description section. So let's get started. Indian Navy presently have no nuclear attack submarine or SSNs in position after the return of INS Chakra 2. Navy has signed a contract worth $3 billion with Russia for leasing another Akula class submarine, namely INS Chakra 3, by 2026. Talks are in progress for leasing one more Akula class submarine with Russia. Lack of SSN is a big capability gap for Indian Navy. The SSN deal is equally important from French perspective. The cancellation of contract between French Naval Group and Australia has created a void, and overall deal has been great loss for France. This financial loss can only be fulfilled through huge submarine orders, and India is a suitable candidate for that purpose. Presently, India is set to acquire 6 SSNs under Project 75 Alpha. The overall cost of building these submarines will be around 1.2 lakh crore in Indian rupees. This amount is huge. It is greater than the combined deal of S-400 ADS and 36 Rafales. Under the Project 75 Alpha, the Indian Navy aims to procure 6 new nuclear-powered attack submarine SSNs. The Government of India approved the construction of 6 such submarines in February 2015. These will be designed by Navy's in-house Directorate of Naval Design and built in India at Shipbuilding Center at Vishakhapatnam. The construction is expected to start on 2023-24, while the first submarine is expected to enter service by 2032. But considering the recent development and the history of submarine development, it may take 2035 to induct these submarines into Indian Navy. For example, it took almost 13 years to build and induct Barracuda class submarine into French Navy with 2 years of delay. So in order to fast track the construction of SSNs, Navy should go for proven technology where design work has already completed, and based on similar design, SSNs should be built. This will save a huge amount of time. French Barracuda class submarine completely fits Indian Navy's requirement, and this is the reason why many think tanks are backing the French Barracuda class submarines. Talking about Barracuda class submarine or Suffren class, it is very close to British and American submarines in overall capabilities. However, the Suffren remains a more compact submarine, packing many of the latest technologies into a relatively smaller hull. This makes it very interesting. 6 Suffren class submarines will form the backbone of French Navy. Suffren is significantly larger than the preceding Amethyst class. They are more than double the displacement at 5,300 tons versus 2,700 tons. While the French Navy has used Amethyst boats on extended deployments, it is natural that larger Suffren class will be better suited. The submarine has state-of-art pump jet propulsion system and X rudders in place of a regular screw and cruciform control surfaces. The Barracuda class nuclear reactor incorporates several improvements over that of preceding Amethyst. This extends the time between refueling and complex overhauls from 7 to 10 years, enabling higher at-sea availability. It uses nuclear electric propulsion, where the screw is turned by electric motor and not by steam turbine with reduced gearing like most other submarines. This is silent and allows integration of batteries to make it more silent. It uses a 150 megawatt reactor, two 10 megawatt turbo generator groups, large batteries that allow submarine to run at minimum reactor power for several days in near perfect noiseless, and two 480 kilowatt emergency diesel generators. This class reportedly produces 1000 times lesser detectable noise than that of its predecessors, and they are 10 times more sensitive in detecting. So they are more powerful, advanced and stealthier than any other submarines in its category. Now, talking about countermeasures, it has Nemesis countermeasure system based on Contralto from Naval Group, which applies a confusion or dilution principle and combines evasive maneuvers with the deployment of Canto-S decoys. Talking about its main sensor, it uses hull and flank sonar arrays, towed sonar array, mine and obstacle avoidance sensors, active sonar warning receiver, navigation sonar, attack photonics mast, and surveillance photonics mast. The submarine will be able to perform multiple operations such as anti-surface and anti-submarine warfare, land attack, intelligence gathering, crisis management, and special operations. In support of special operation missions, Barracudas may also accommodate up to 15 commandos while carrying their equipment in a mobile pod attached aft of the sail. Talking about its armament, it has four 533 mm torpedo tubes with 20 storage racks capacity, including MDCN, SCALP naval missiles, Exocet, SM-39, Mod 2 anti-ship missiles, A3SM Mica missiles, F-21 Artemis heavy torpedoes, and FG-29 mines. In future, torpedo-sized UUVs, uncrewed underwater vehicles, may also be carried. Naval Group's new T-19 type might be ideally suited. Small UUVs can carry out a wider range of missions, including intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance, electronic warfare, anti-submarine warfare, mine countermeasures and mine warfare.
This was today's update. Please let us know what is your views about these in comment section. Feel free to post your comments and suggestions about any topic related to defense sector on which you want to hear from us. With this, I would like to say goodbye and Jai Hind, friends. Please like and subscribe our video if you have not done already. We'll be soon back with more interesting and amazing development happening in defense sector.